Hi and welcome back to another tutorial about creating such round looking texture in ZBrush with the help of the masks that we're going to create in Photoshop. So we're going to be creating this one and this one. It's the same process, but the creation of the masks in Photoshop is a little bit different. So let's get started. Open Photoshop, file, new, 1024 by 1024 RGB, and OK. Create a new layer, set the colors to black and white, filter, render clouds, and filter gallery, and under texture select stained glass for the cell size 46, for the border thickness 13, and light intensity 0. Press OK. Add another levels adjustment layer and push this middle arrow to the left, and another one, another level adjustment layer, so we get rid of grayish looking parts. Select all three layers by holding shift and pressing Ctrl E on the keyboard to merge them together. This way we created a basic shape of our masks. So we're going to go to file, save as, and go to your folder where you want to have your maps saved. Save it as JPEG and name it and save it. Now we are going to be creating base for this mask. Back to Photoshop, create a new layer and select brush, let's say 5 pixels, and select black color and just click and hold shift and drag down to create a straight line. Make 4 of them and make sure you click with the mouse first before you press shift, and and click, hold shift and drag, click, hold shift and drag. Now this is really too uniform for me, so I just select a rectangular marquee tool, select some area, pressing V on the keyboard to go to move tool and just move this down a little bit, press Ctrl D on the keyboard to deselect everything, and press M on the keyboard to go back to marquee selection tool, V on the keyboard, and reposition this one, and you can see, you can get a picture, what you can do with this. So if you would like, you can go to brush and just draw out some of the new lines, click and hold shift and click again, and hold shift and click again. This way you will have a non-uniform looking mask, and you could also move something like this, and then back to brush, Ctrl D to deselect everything, and then just click and hold shift and click on the other end part, and you get another shape. So when you are satisfied, you can save it, but make sure if you want to use this one as a seamless map that you don't reposition the lines on the edges, because this is really seamless with this part. So if you want to create something unique, you could go in and just draw out something like this and maybe delete this, so you just play around and make sure your map looks unique. then just again File, Save As, JPEG, and save it. And now we're going to create a map for this one. Back to Photoshop, new layer, under ellipse tool, make sure you have shape selected, fill 0, stroke black, and make it, let's say, 6 points, and click somewhere in the middle, or you can control R on the keyboard to make the rulers visible and just drag it out until it snaps to the center, and snaps to the center, and now you can draw out. And while you are drawing, you can hold Alt to draw from the center and holding Shift to make it circular. Let go everything and the shape is created. Control J on the keyboard to duplicate it, Control T on the keyboard and just resize it. Press Enter on the keyboard, Control J to duplicate it again, Enter, Control J to duplicate it again, Enter. Enter 2 times, and now you can V on the keyboard, just get rid of this one, just draw them out, Control R on the keyboard to get rid of the rulers, and under new layer you just select brush and click and hold shift and click. You see how easy it is? You just have to play around, do some drawings that you like, that you would like your texture to have, and then just save it. I won't do this till the end, but you get the picture. Just File, Save As, and save as JPEG. And now back to ZBrush. We are going to start with plain 3D. Plain 3D, and make a poly mesh out of it. And under geometry, we're going to turn off smooth and divide it a couple of times, let's say 5 levels. And here under standard, we're going to click on alpha and import and go to your folder where you saved your alphas that you just created in ZBrush, in Photoshop, sorry. And let's just bring them in. Circle. Let's make a circle first. Let's just, yeah. Now under masking, mask by alpha, open mask by alpha, and mask by alpha. Set intensity and blend to 100 as default. And now the alpha is applied to the plane. Press Ctrl W on the keyboard to make one polygroup out of the masked selection. Shift F to see it. It's pretty hard to see now. And sometimes when the lines are too thin, like here, we can see it had hard time to, it didn't do the trick. So if this happens, we just undo and apply again, and on masking we're going to grow mask, let's say 2 times, maybe sharpen it a little bit. And now we're going to press Ctrl W on the keyboard, press Shift F, and now we can see we get this really nice distribution of different parts. So now we are going to press control shift and click on these borders and click control shift and click and drag on the canvas to reverse the selection. And under polygroups we are going to auto group it. This way each of the bricks is going to be created as separate polygroup. Now we're going to hide this one and go under, where are you, geometry, modify topology and delete hidden. And now because we have multiple subdivision, it won't let us do this, but we are going to do this anyway by deleting the lower divisions, and again delete hidden. Now if we control shift and click and drag on the canvas, we can see we get nothing. So now we are going to try to make some volume, because this is only a plane and we want the volume. Where are you now? I really love when this happens. Come on. Sometimes you have to turn on double. No. Where the fuck are you? I don't know what happened. Obviously the shortcuts for centering don't work when I'm recording, so sorry about that. So let's get the volume to these parts. So under geometry we're going to use edge loops, and under panel loops we're going to set this to 1, thickness to 0.1, bevel 0, and let's hope ZBrush doesn't crash panel loop. And we can see, bam, we immediately get some volume. And if we turn on polyframe, we can see it's all different polygroups. So again we're going to go to polygroups and autogroup again. Let's wait a second, pressing shift F on the, and we can see we have only one polygroup for each object. But as we can see here, the polys are really not distributed okay. So if we would turn off this and turn off this, and we would try to sculpt it, the top part is pretty okay. If we would subdivide it, it would be even better. But the part, the side doesn't react really as we would expect, because it has only this horizontal, and not the squares are not as we can see them here. So I'm going to undo this, and to fix this, I'm going to go to geometry. And where are you? Geometry, zero measure. I'm going to zero mesh it and click on same and just click on zero mesh. It will take some time, maybe a minute or two. So let me pause this video. So we are back, and now the zero mesher has done his magic. And if we turn on shift F polyframe, we can see the polygons are redistributed and ready to sculpt. So this is pretty much it about the technique, how you can use masks created in Photoshop for quick creation of objects in your ZBrush. So the same I had, that I used the same technique for creating this one, exactly the same, starting with plain 3D, poly mesh it, apply an alpha under masking, and then grouping it together, deleting the unnecessary parts like this between, and then just what is it what was it called? Edge loop and panel loops with settings 1.1 or 0.2 and bevel to 0. And this is it. This is the magic. Zero mesh it and start sculpting. So, this was it for this tutorial. Check out the rest of my videos. Subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to share this video. Until next time. Bye.